Hi.
Hello, hello.
I don't want you.
And I give you Mari.
Hi. Looking good. Are you gonna take those colors out before the wedding? Cause I mean, they're nice and everything, but
they give
like
a certain look.
They're orange. Oh,
I know the tropical thing. I get it.
Yeah,
it really well.
And then we'll put those feathers over there on the side.
Look at her. Isn't she stunning?
Gorgeous. Hi, pretty.
Excellent. We're getting you your new table. Everything's awesome. Everything's working out really well.
Hey, take my, when you go, take my phone upstairs because my photographer might be
trying to call me right now and
he
just can't reach me. Yeah.
Okay.
What should I tap?
You're
supposed to be here at 4.
Okay, so jitters, nervousness, stress, what's going on?
Well, I was just trying to get ready today. Yeah, this morning.
Oh, no. It's just when you want your wedding video, right?
Yeah. Exactly what I want on my wedding video.
I can edit that out. Don't worry, Steph. I can edit that out.
no real jitters.
Yeah.
Daddy just almost made me cry at lunch because he said something that just reminded me of the good old days. The good old me and Daddy, when it was just me and Daddy and there was no such thing as Paul. And it, not that those are the good old days, because I'm sure Paul and I had great days together, but it was a childhood thing that he brought up, and I almost lost it. Kathleen was like, stop that! She started hitting me. So, it was
insane. So what were you doing this morning? What kind of planning and...
Well, I just was there whenever the florist showed up, and... flowers are absolutely beautiful. I could not be happier. Like,
yeah, you're definitely gonna have to get a lot of shots.
There's just nothing better than those flowers. They are amazing.
Did you see it yet,
Mari? And
no, we just met. We greeted everyone outside.
You have to go.
Yeah. I'll go scope it out.
And all my attendants have just been amazing and wonderful, and they couldn't be better.
Yay!
There's one of them right there.
If this phone starts to ring, what do I tell your photographer?
Tell him down here to come down here.
Okay. Alrighty then.
We're gonna go hula, and maybe I'll borrow your friend to do some makeup.
You're gonna hula?
Yes.
Yeah. Yay, good. You're gonna practice hula.
Yes. And then I'm gonna go get my hair done too. So. Okay. We're gonna see how Paul's doing. You know, see if he's got any pre-wedding jitters. This is the last moment. Oh.
Hi.
Say hi. Ooh, girl. So pretty. Hi.
Hey.
Hi. So this is just minutes before the wedding.
Okay, minutes before the wedding.
Minutes before the wedding.
Are you recording?
How do you feel?
Three shots of Jack Daniels ago, I was quite nervous. But now, I'm feeling wonderful. I actually didn't drink anything. I'm just feeling 8 hours of sleep.
Oh, look at you. You're glowing.
I'm glowing.
You're so happy.
Partly because I'm happy, partly because it's about 95 degrees.
Yeah,
you can't
sweating.
Really tell.
I'm definitely
but,
sweating.
Yeah. I'm ready.
Oh, look at that. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
behave yourself, please let it matter. You just say, oh, yeah, don't answer for him now. When you love and know each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives. When you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church. Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, I ask that you face each other, take one's hand, and declare your consent. You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in His goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with His blessings. What God has joined humanity must not divide. And are you giving rings to each other as a sign of your love? I ask that you bring it before. Blow out the two family candles as a sign that it's a new family. they've got together before they leave the church as husband and wife.
Exactly. Kiss the bride. Kiss her!
Something feels swishy.
Oh.
That's lovely.
Oh,
Otherwise, she'd be in trouble.
Whoa!
No, I know. I'm trying to fill up.
I know you're trying to fill up.
What are you trying to find?
There's a button. This should be right here. Got it.
You found the button.
No, that's a zipper. What's a zipper?
Huh.
What is
this? Dude, give the bride some dignity.
I got it. Sorry.
You can't find buttons on your
right. Yeah. No, I'm just looking along the way around. I'm definitely looking in the inside layers.
It's even funnier that we're videotaping it.
Yes.
I love singing in weddings because everybody looks lovely, especially the bride and your mom too. Where is Mrs. Kennedy? There she is. Okay, this is for Stephanie and the mama. Maestro. Oh, wait. When I'm awfully alone, when the world is cold, I will feel the glow. Just think of you, just the way you look tonight. There is nothing for me but to love you, just the way you look tonight. Touches my foolish heart. Oh, you're lovely. Please don't ever change. Keep the breathless smile. Won't you please arrange it? 'Cause I love you just the way you look tonight. How about one more for Stephanie Kennedy Enriquez? Ladies, world, your tender keep your pockets open, tearing my fears apart. Oh, yeah, and the laugh that wrinkles that nose, it just touches his foolish heart. Yeah. Find a girl. settle down. And if you want, you can marry me. Look at me, I am old, but I'm happy. I was once like you and now, and I know that it's not easy to become when you found something's going on. But take your time, think a lot, think of everything that you've got. You will still be here tomorrow, though your dreams may be gone.
Is it on? Well, I know that everybody here has come a long ways, or a short way, but there's most of you has come a very long ways. And I know that Stephanie and Paul must mean a lot to you for you to make that effort. I love them, as you can see, I love them dearly, and I'm just so glad that they were able to have this time with all of their friends and family. As you can see, there has been a lot of people that have made a huge effort in putting this together. And it's just beautiful. I actually didn't do very much at all. but I think it's wonderful. It's the bouquets are beautiful. Whoever the florist was, that's just the best job I've ever seen. Of course, the church and Father Murphy took my breath away. It was a beautiful church, a beautiful ceremony. I could have not asked for any more for my daughter and Paul. And I know that Paul's parents put a lot of effort into this. And I couldn't thank them more than I feel right now. It's just it takes my breath away. I just can't believe how nice that it is that everybody's come out and has put so much effort into this. And of course, my daughter, I spent so much time with raising her. And when I hear people laugh, I think of her and me together. And I never really knew that somebody could take my place because I entertained her all the time. And then Paul came along, and of course I realized that somebody could. I love you, Paul. I welcome you to the family, and your family is beautiful, and I welcome the entire Enriquez family to our family. Actually, it's my pleasure. All I can say is, you're here.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we will honor our bride and groom with a toast from, do you have your champagnes ready now? Oh, not yet? Where are some champagne?
Your face.
Oh, yeah. Okay, we're gonna
shooting shields, breaking all the rules. Two hitters, man, two
hitters.
Man, two hitters. Shining like a chandelier. Diamonds up in my eyes. Look at the trophy on my neck. I'm dangling way, way, way. Too much candy on my wall. Too many rumors out in line. I be haters on the side. My life ain't concerned. It's not all for a smile. I'm gonna do some damn.
me. When we were little girls, you taught me how to make mud pies and kept me from eating them. You taught me how to put on makeup and paint my nails. You showed me how to dance and were by my side through my mistakes. You coached me through my first crush and covered for me when I came in late from a date. If Dad tickled me, you would laugh. When I scraped my knee, you needed a bandage too. I even liked it when you would come into my room and sit with me when I was sad, even though I told you to go away. And when you got married today, I cried tears of joy with you because that is what it means to be a sister. So now when Dad tickles me, you still laugh and Paul may wonder what you're up to. And today you're still leading the way, shining a light on the path of love and marriage, showing me how it's done and sometimes what not to do. How wonderful it is to see that you found the perfect man for you. I was proud to stand by your side when you said I do. You took a big step towards your future today and in turn gave me a gift of a brother. As you begin this new chapter in your life, I will still look up to you for guidance because you helped me get this far, and how blessed I am to have a big sister like you. Congratulations.
All right, I'm going to try to top that.
Yeah.
Anyways, I'm Dan, I'm the best man. I actually know Paul. We've been best friends for about, I don't know, 10 years maybe now? And I told him I try not to embarrass him too much, but I had to kind of say our first story I met Paul was the first day of 8th grade. He just moved down here from Galveston, over here to the lake, and you know, thought he was Mr. Cool. Thought he had to prove himself. First day of school, this guy actually beats up my friend at the time. And at that moment, I realized, wow, this guy definitely needs to be my friend. So I actually came home that day and told my mom, I think I may have found a bodyguard. So, yeah. From then on, we were best friends. I couldn't have asked for a better person to be friends than Paul. Always had my back, always there for me. Or I should call him, I guess, Bear now. So,
Bear,
I'm sorry. See, the other thing with that is, we used to call him Teddy. Because this is, you know, Paul's wise wisdom once said that even if he was a really big guy, he was a little intimidating, you know, kind of scary, right? He was a bear at heart, and I always thought that was very cute and lame. So, but it's been a blast being friends with him, and I can still remember him telling me all about Stephanie, you know, how great this girl was, and I was like, man, what, you know, what's about this girl? So, you know, I saw her finally, and it didn't take me very long to realize, you know, what he saw in her. And it's been a blast watching the two of them together. You know, they both, you know, I think brighten each other's days. They complement each other perfectly. And it's been joy getting to know Stephanie. I always thought me and Paul would be end up together, but I guess Stephanie will have to do. So, I know they'll make a great couple. And, you know, I can't say much more. Except for Mr. Kennedy, you know, takes a real man to give away an angel. So, there you go. To see you guys.
Is that from Wedding Crashers?
Here's to an awesome, wonderful life for Paul and Stephanie Kennedy. I mean, Enriquez. So, all right, Kennedy Enriquez.
Thank you, Dan and Melissa. Now it's time to cut the cake. Are we ready with the cake?
Do they have to get up and cut?
Thank you.
punch.
The 5, 6, 7, 8. Well, he was gonna do an intro. Okay. 5, 6, 7, 8. Begin for them.
Oh, in Beaumont. Thank you very much.
So basically, we're here because I was sitting in a table at Starbucks about a year and a half ago. And this is my side of the story. Stephanie doesn't like this story. But what I like to say is I was sitting at a table at Starbucks, and this really hot girl walked in and tapped me on the shoulder and said, "I'm gonna marry you." No, that didn't really happen. our first date was at a Starbucks, and you know, I was there first, and she tapped me on the shoulder, and when I turned around, and she just took my breath away. She's so beautiful, and you know, I love her very much. That's it for me. Thanks everybody for coming. The money dance, obviously, very nice. And I'll pass it over to my beautiful bride.
So, Paul told his side of the story, and I'll tell mine. Before Paul and I met, my friend Kathleen got married, and I was at her wedding. And after the wedding, I asked her how they met, and she told me, or how she knew, rather, and she told me that when she met her husband, she walked in the room, and he was facing her, he was turned around, and she said, "Waves," and she went, "Waves," came over her. You know you did too. And waves came over her, and I thought, I didn't think, "God, that's goofy," which probably some of y'all might think. I thought, "Oh my God, I wish I could feel that way about someone. I've never felt that way about anybody." And we were set up, and I was told to come to a Starbucks. And as I was walking up to that Starbucks, I could see through the glass window. It was all lit up and frosty. The glass was frosty, and it was just January. And I looked in, and it was crowded, and my eyes fixed on this one person. And waves came over me. Waves. And I could not stop smiling. And I don't think I ever did. My face hurt. My face hurt for weeks. I couldn't stop smiling. And I knew right then that he was the one, and that I had to do everything that I could to keep myself toned down so that I could keep him around long enough to fall in love with me. So thank you everyone for coming and sharing with us, because this is so magical. I mean, our whole, how we met, and I mean, you know, it was just a whirlwind. You know, we met on Wednesday. We decided we needed to be together on Saturday. 2 months later, he told me he was going to marry me. And a couple months later from that, we got engaged, and we're here today. And I just can't believe it. I mean, I just cannot believe how happy and how changed my life is. And I just thank you all for taking part in my happiness. To say that I could not marry into a better family, but you can't either, so. Thank you, everyone.
Okay, thank you, Paul and Stephanie, and I believe we only have 15 minutes left before we call it a night, so let's all open the dance floor and have fun.
I don't agree with it. Everyone is entitled to their own opinion.
Yeah.
And then, but she still wouldn't let it go. Like, she let it go for then, but later on when it was just me and her, she was like, "I just don't understand, like, how can a group of people label an entire group, like, labeling all Christians as bad and horrible and blah, blah, blah." And I was like, "Dude, there's radical points of view in every single group. There are radical Catholics who say gay people are going to hell. There are radical gay people who say all Christians are evil. Like, it's just gonna happen. You have people blowing themselves up. You're not questioning that. That, you know, like, let it go. That's just the way life is."
Okay, radical back on the fire. Female. I really love that you like that line. You're like, "Oh my gosh." Sorry, we're talking about something
else. In another language, thank you very much, that I cannot understand. Are y'all talking in Latin?
We're talking about English.
There's this
what was it? You know, there's this reggaeton song. You know it. You know what Calle 13?
No, it's reggaeton.
Atrévete.
That's got a good beat, that song. Since I can't understand it, but then I'm always listening to the beat.
No, it's a little Anyway, no, there's a part where he's like, get back to that, like, it's gonna explode, like, it's on your legs, explode, you know? Dancing, you know? And then it's like, gonna explode, like a Palestinian.
Oh, really?
It's like really like the whole thing is like his lyrics are ridiculous. They're really creative, like the way he says it, but like they're really like dirty, like very sexually dirty and very just really controversial. And, like, I love it though.
Fuck
war.
Ew.
That, Galveston's rough today.